Hallelujah and blessings in Jesus, friends. Welcome back to Hayakadosh Ministries, where holiness is a way of life. Jesus is truly King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and the Holy Bible, praise God, is our only standard and authority for truth. And together God's people say, Hallelujah. Well, friends, this is a festive time for us. Not only is it rolling over into the new year, the year of our Lord 2018, but this signifies 1 year that One a Day has been on the internet. Now, a couple of you have been with us since the very beginning, and I'm so thankful for you and those who have joined us throughout the year. And it is my prayer that you are growing in the knowledge of the Word of God, which is thereby changing your behavior and causing you to be a better follower of the Lord Jesus each and every day. But I wanted to take this opportunity to just pause and reflect on the past year. Now, as we look back on this year, both you and I together, there would be what we might consider some regrets. But friends, let these not be regrets, but lessons learned. And let us do everything in our power to make sure that we don't make the same mistakes again. So if you have problems with a particular habit, I pray that the Lord Jesus will give you victory over that habit, because He's given you His Spirit, which enables you to walk in victory. If there's an emotional problem that you've been experiencing, anger, jealousy, bitterness, selfishness, holding grudges, and things like these, I pray that you will gain self-control that will be exercised as you discipline yourself not to follow your emotions, not to give in to your feelings. If there's some worldly aspect that you're holding on to, that you know the Lord wants to deliver you from, I pray that you'll realize that this is your responsibility, part of the sanctifying process in your life, to sacrifice these things, to give these things up for the greater glory of the Lord. And so as we move into this new year, there are probably many hopes that you carry into the new year with you. Hopes that you may read your Bible more, that you may be more consistent in continual fellowship with your Lord, that you will give more of yourselves unto others and care less about yourself, your own wants, and your own desires. And so as we look back over this last year, there are many victories that we see, many successes, and of course, there are many failures, many mistakes along the way. And we know if we confess those mistakes unto the Lord that He's faithful and just to forgive us, to cleanse us from all unrighteousness, and empower us through His Holy Spirit not to make those same mistakes again. And it's important that we focus upon what someone said long ago. I may not be the man of God. I may not be the woman of God I so desire to be. But praise God, I'm not the man. I'm not the woman I used to be. And so when you think back over this last year and you take yourself to January 1st of 2017, how different are you today? Are you a better follower of the Lord Jesus? Are you more committed to the things that are important to Him? Are you giving yourselves more to His holy disciplines? Are you growing in the knowledge of His Word? Do you sense a state of peace and rest that maybe this time last year you didn't even know was possible? Do you find yourself desiring the things that God loves and abhorring the things that God hates? Well, friends, that's what our journey is all about, continual progress, becoming more like the man Jesus when He walked this earth, giving Himself in full obedience to God so that we can know we're doing everything in our power to meet that same level of obedience, or as Jesus said, that same level of perfection, of maturity. Be ye perfect as your Father in heaven is perfect. That is a huge goal for the Christian life, but that is our goal and that is our command. And so it is my prayer through this ministry and other ministries that are giving you the uncompromised Word of God, men of great service and faithfulness unto the Lord, that you can truly say of yourself, I haven't achieved the mark that's set before me, but I'll let nothing stand in the way or hinder me in pursuing with great effort the prize of the higher calling. Now, of course, today being January the 1st in the year of our Lord 2018, we are beginning afresh our reading of the New Testament. And we simply do this by reading 5 chapters of the New Testament every single day. And if you do that, you'll read the New Testament once every 2 months or 6 times a year. And there's nothing better that you can do in your growth in the spiritual life than the reading of God's Word, friends. And so I strongly encourage you to take upon yourself this discipline so that this time next year you can look back and truly see the results that it has made in your Christian journey, in your journey to be a better follower of the Lord Jesus. And out of all the resolutions that you could make going into the next year, that is the greatest resolution that you can make for yourself. Well, with that being said, I just wanted to take a moment to encourage you in the new year and to tell you how much I love each one of you and how thankful I am for the opportunity to bring you the Word of God each and every day. Many of you I have communicated with through messages left under each video. Some of you have become very dear friends through email and even talking together on the phone. But regardless whether we have communicated or not, I pray for you each and every day. And my prayer is that you'll take what you hear through this ministry and apply it to your lives so that others, even though they may mock you, they may jest about you, in the depths of their heart, they know that they've never met anyone as committed as you, as devoted as you, as in love with Jesus and His Word as you. And if that's said about you through something that we offer in this ministry, that brings my heart much joy. Well, before we end this morning, one last thing that I would like to mention, friends, is that as we roll into the new year, we know that there were those last year who said, "The Lord is coming back." And it seems as if every year there's always someone somewhere that is making such a claim. And many believe such things. And even when the evidence seems to be so reliable, even when all the pieces seem to fit together, we see that once again, people that are speaking these prophecies, people who are propagating these claims, are once again wrong. And I can assure you, friends, as we roll into the year of our Lord 2018, there will be those that again will make such claims. And so I simply want to remind you of what the Lord Jesus said when He said, "Take no thought for tomorrow, but put all your effort into living righteously today. For today is full of evil, full of temptations, full of trials. And each day as you experience is so full of these evils that this will preoccupy your full day if you will give yourself only to the attention of what is taking place in that day." Jesus, in His last appearance to the disciples in Acts chapter 1, tells them that John truly baptized with water in verse 5, but you will be baptized, you will be submerged with the Holy Ghost. And the purpose of the Holy Ghost given to us as His followers is so that we can live victoriously each and every day over and above sin. And if you don't believe that, simply read Romans chapter 6. But then it tells us, when they were come together, they asked of Him, saying, "Lord, Jesus, Master, Messiah, will you at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? Is it time for the restoration of all things?" And He said unto them, "It is not for you to know the times or the seasons, which the Father has put in His power." In other words, don't preoccupy yourselves on things that you have no control over. Don't spend your time pursuing such details and be caught up in things that no one really knows. It's in the Father's power when all things shall come to an end. You should be more concerned that the Holy Ghost has come upon you and you shall be witnesses unto Me. And so Jesus is basically saying, spend every day living as faithfully for Me, doing the things that I've commanded you each and every day, and let the future take care of itself. Post-trib, pre-trib, mid-trib really isn't important if you're living daily for Me, for it doesn't matter when I come back, you won't be caught by surprise. And so as we move into this new year, friends, I truly want to challenge you to consider the things that you spend the majority of your time upon, the things that you think about, the things that you pursue, maybe even the debates that you get involved in. Because what you're going to find is that many of the things which we desire to know aren't important to our practical Christian daily living. And therefore, really, they serve no purpose rather than tickle our intellect. And so I want you to focus on what it really means to be a daily follower of the Lord Jesus and to deny yourself when you feel compelled to chase after such needless things. Well, friends, we're going to close there today. And it is my prayer that your journey will be blessed. I look forward to spending each day with you as the Lord blesses us with each new day throughout this coming year. And I look forward, most forward, to the great themes that the Lord is going to teach us and enlighten us to when it comes to the revelation of His truth. May this new year be full of spiritual blessing for you. Now as He, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit desires, I'll see you on the next video.